It came at a really interesting time, my sister's wedding. And because there was this case before the Supreme Court. It was called Masterpiece Cake Shop versus the state of Colorado. And if you don't know what it is, essentially these two dudes were getting married and they wanted to get a cake and they went into Masterpiece Cake Shop and the guy who ran that was like, no, no gay cakes here. I don't like gay things. You named your cake shop Masterpiece. Calm down. And they wanted to get a cake and he was like, no, I'm not going to do it because making a cake is my art. And I don't want my art to serve something I don't support. Which I am in full support of the culinary arts. I think they're wonderful and fantastic. But the last wedding you went to, who made the cake? Yeah, you don't know. You don't. The only person who really cares about a cake at a wedding is your diabetic Aunt Debbie, who's like, is it moist? No, my apple's great. Is it moist? How? It also kind of, like, his argument presupposes that every gay wedding is just themed gay. Which is not true. Gay weddings have a bunch of themes. There's Wizard of Oz. There's Melissa Etheridge. There's woodworking. That's a bisexual theme, by the way. It goes both ways. I don't want to get down on marriage. I think marriage is great. I was close to marriage once with an ex. We'll call her Amanda, even though her name's Melissa. And I'm kidding. Amanda and Melissa actually are the names of two of my exes, but I would never do that. I would never really name someone and then talk about them on stage. So Amanda and Melissa, if you're listening, this isn't about you. It's about Chelsea. So Chelsea and I... Chelsea and I were together for around 4 years, and we were talking about marriage, but then things went sour when she cheated on me with a mutual friend named Steph. And that, I know, it, yeah. I think that was my mom. We're only doing one recording of this, Ma. Come on. But Chelsea cheated on me with a mutual friend. And that hurt. Because I wanted to fuck Steph. Do you understand the type of... She was like, I slept with Steph. I was like, oh God, Jesus, did she ask about me or anything? I brought up it all. I couldn't blame Chelsea, though, because I was on tour a lot. I was in and out of town, and you know that old saying, out of sight, into Steph, so it made sense. I went to my friend Tommy for some consoling around that time. And Tommy's advice to me was, Whitney. Whitney. Don't hate the player. Hate the game. What? It's called cheating. If Steph Curry started hitting people in the head with a hammer during playoffs, you wouldn't be like, I hate basketball. To be fair, I don't even know if I could call what Chelsea did cheating, because I don't even know if we were playing the same game. You know, like, I was playing the game of life, and she was playing this hybrid mixture of risk, trouble, and sorry. Like, I was over in the corner flipping cards for Candyland, she was over in the corner flicking spinners for Chutes and Ladders. So it was different games. And I don't need a Candyland relationship, by the way. I don't. I'm fine with Chutes and Ladders. I love Chutes and Ladders. Come out with me sometime. I ladder up so many chutes. But I need to know that's the game we're playing, you know?